I've always been fascinated with medieval art, especially that of the more strange, lurid, or infernal variety. And one recurring motif in particular that's long captured my imagination is that of the so-called Hellmouth, or the Jaws of Hell. Essentially, the Hellmouth is the entrance of Hell depicted as the gaping maw of a giant beast. Usually, the creature's jaws are packed full of frightened or tormented sinners. In some cases, the Hellmouth motif incorporates another theme I've long been fascinated by, the harrowing of hell. The harrowing of hell refers to Christ's temporary descent into hell or the underworld, following his bodily death on the cross, as referenced in the Apostles and Athanasian creeds. Christ is usually depicted as standing outside the Hellmouth, guiding the righteous out by the hand. In general, the figures being rescued are thought to be virtuous pre-Christian individuals who had died prior to Christ bringing his message of salvation to the earth. More specifically, they are figures such as the Old Testament patriarchs and the so-called noble pagans. The Hellmouth motif is thought to have originated in Anglo-Saxon art, and one theory about its origins is that it may be a remnant of the pagan past that survived Christian assimilation. An echo of the fearsome giant wolf Fenrir that swallows Odin at the end of time. Supposedly, the harrowing of hell appealed to Anglo-Saxon military sensibilities, and they viewed it as an example of a successful campaign or raid, Christ triumphantly breaching the gates and rescuing hell's captives. The motif would spread throughout Europe, but according to late art historian Meyer Shapiro, the earliest example of a beast or animal-headed hellmouth is an ivory carving dating to roughly 800 CE. Most examples dating before the 12th century are English, testifying to its proposed Anglo-Saxon origins. Whether or not the bestial image of the Hellmouth is meant to represent the very head and jaws of Satan seems to be a matter of some scholarly contention. But it's interesting to note that in the Vercelli homilies, a collection of prose within the so-called Vercelli book, an Anglo-Saxon codex dating to the late 10th century, Satan is likened to a consuming dragon. They never come out of the pit of snakes and of the throat of the dragon, which is called Satan. Another 10th century Anglo-Saxon codex, the Book of Exeter, contains an Old English poem called The Whale that seems to liken the mouth of hell to the maw of a whale or the biblical Leviathan. The whale has another trick. When he is hungry, he opens his mouth and a sweet smell comes out. The fish are tricked by the smell and they enter into his mouth. Suddenly, the whale's jaws close. Likewise, any man who lets himself be tricked by a sweet smell and led to sin will go into hell, opened by the devil. If he has followed the pleasures of the body and not those of the spirit, when the devil has brought them to hell, he clashes together the jaws, the gates of hell. No one can get out from them, just as no fish can escape from the mouth of the whale. In medieval theater, a hellmouth prop was often utilized, sometimes as part of a so-called pageant wagon, a kind of movable stage used in medieval miracle and mystery plays. The popularity of the motif, often combined with Last Judgment and the aforementioned harrowing of hell themes, dwindled by the end of the Middle Ages, but continued on to some extent into the Renaissance. It saw a revival in the wake of the Protestant Reformation, appearing in what are called popular prints, a kind of early example of mass media, printed images usually of low artistic quality, sold cheaply to the public. Near the end of the 16th century, Greek-born Renaissance artist Domenikos Theotokopoulos, better known as El Greco, employed the image in two versions of his painting entitled Adoration of the Holy Name of Jesus. A hellmouth in the form of the head of a leviathan appears in the lower right. El Greco's take on the hellmouth theme was supposedly influenced by the work of famous Dutch painter Hieronymus Bosch, who, widely known for his strange and lurid imagery, employed the theme in some of his own works. While researching this episode, I encountered numerous claims that the theme occasionally appeared later in political cartoons, including a specific example that piqued my interest, depicting Napoleon leading his troops into a Hellmouth's yawning jaws, but unfortunately I was unable to track down the actual image. As for its influence on pop culture, Hellmouth is the name of a hardcore punk band, the name of a 2014 Canadian horror film, and I suppose I would be remiss if I didn't mention that yes, a so-called Hellmouth was a reoccurring plot point in the Buffy the Vampire Slayer TV series, which ran from 1997 to 2003. Well, I hope you enjoyed this special documentary episode of The Week in Doubt. As always, thanks for listening.